excited and ready to get going. Just wanted to go ahead and introduce, first my staff is Christina Harvey. She comes to us from Gannon University. She started in June, I started in April, so we're both new here, and she is probably one of the hardest working assistants I've been around in my tenure of coaching. So very fortunate to have her. She's a great player at Pfeiffer University, all-conference player, so we're just very blessed to have her on staff. Preseason has wrapped up, so we are in our official season. Just want to talk a little bit about preseason and kind of what that entails and what we've accomplished so far. Preseason started when we started school. So the week after the students got here, we started our preseason. We did a lot of conditioning and a lot of running and a lot of challenging our team physically, which challenged them mentally. So we've done a lot of preparation in that in the preseason. That was about an 8-week process. During that time, we had 8 hours with them a week. So we spent 4 of those on the court with the basketball, and then 4 conditioning and weight training and team meetings and those things. So we feel like we've prepared them pretty well, and they worked really hard in our preseason. I'm very pleased with the work they did and the strides that we made. So that phase is over, and we are 7 days in, 7 practices in, excuse me, to official practice. We started on October 15th, and we've been making some strides in official practice. So we get 20 hours a week right now with them, and we are using those hours. We are doing a lot of film study, a lot of on-court teaching. We're more in the teaching mode now, so we are trying to implement our brand of basketball a little bit more and really teach the principles and the style of basketball that we want to play going forward. What our team looks like right now going forward. We've got 8 players that are returning from last season's team, and we've got 8 brand new players. So as you know, implementing and then with us being a new staff, implementing all the new, everybody's new right now. So getting that chemistry and implementing the new players. We grabbed 3 players late and signed 3. We had 5 that were already committed when we got here by the previous coaching staff, and then 8 players that are returning from last year's team. So we've got a good group. We're trying to establish our culture and establish what we want to do and our goals going forward for this season and the future. So we've got 6 freshmen, so we're a young team. We've got 6 freshmen coming in. I expect one of our 6'2 posts, her name is Mackenzie Johnson. She's a freshman from Chattanooga, Tennessee. We expect her to come along, and I think she's made some good strides. I expect her to do some things for us immediately this year. We've got 2 transfers that we feel like will impact the game for us. We've got Nia White. She is a junior from Florida Southwestern, and she will play a forward position for us. And then we've got a point guard from Valdosta State who is transferred in as a junior as well, and she will be expected to kind of run things from the point guard spot for us. So our 2 other returners coming back, one Carly Winters, who didn't play for us last year. She transferred from Georgia State. We expect some good things out of her. She's a redshirt freshman, so she's a shooter, and she's probably one of our most talented players in our program. We expect some good things from her on the court. Returning from Sarah Worgan is one of our sophomores who had some really good minutes playing last year. She averaged about 80 points a game for us last year. So she's a slasher, and we expect some good things from her as well. So those are the highlights of our team going forward. Everybody's working hard. The team is working hard. We are trying to establish our goals and our culture, and part of that is doing things the way we want to do them every day and every thing that we do. We have a team quote this year, and it's an old Latin proverb, and I came across it when I was a player, when I was a freshman. So I don't think I really got it then, but it did stick in my mind, and my coach gave me this quote for a reason, I believe. But the quote is, if there's no wind, row. And so that's the motto and the quote that we've adopted for our team. And that's basically what we're trying to teach our student athletes, that there's no excuses and that we are in charge and responsible for what we make of our success will depend on what we can control and what we do. And that's our work ethic, that's our attitude, that's our effort, that's our will to compete every day. And those are things we have full control over. So I think a lot of our players right now are buying into that, and I think we're having more and more buy-in as the days go on. But that's what we want our program to be about. Attitude and effort, controlling what we can. We have, in our practices, we're trying to implement our brand of basketball, which is we want to play a game that we can be proud of, something that we can stamp our name behind. And part of that, being proud of that, is our effort and our will to compete. And that's what we are constantly preaching right now. We have, in our practice plans, we have drills. All of our drills have a side note of a point of emphasis for each drill that we do during the day. And probably we've got a lot of buzzwords going around practice right now, implementing our terminology and really trying to get everyone on the same page. But probably, and my assistant could probably attest to this, probably every point of emphasis that I've typed out so far this year that I've put in those drills is compete. Compete, compete, compete. And that is something that we are harping on, and we are finding players that really want to have the will to fight. We believe that teams that don't want to do the hard things won't compete, and that we want to be a team that does those hard things that other teams are not willing to do. And I firmly believe those are the differences in games. Those are the differences in being successful. So we're on them. We're really staying on them with those things, and like I said, we've got some players who are really buying in, and that they've adopted that, and that you're going to see on the floor that they are going to compete, and they are going to fight, and I'm proud of that effort that we've showed so far. Kind of what's ahead for us coming up? Like we said, we're getting started here, and a lot of excitement. We watched the men's scrimmage yesterday, and the gym is somewhat set up right now, and last night's practice, I was just really pumped because, we got the bleachers out and the chairs are out and I'm just excited. That makes me happy. So we've scrimmaged next week. We start on Monday the 28th. We have a home scrimmage. Next week's going to be pretty packed. So home scrimmage versus Montreal College. Then we've got our purple white game on October 31st, which is Thursday. We're excited to see you all there. And then Friday, November 1st, we will be scrimmaging Piedmont College. So we've got three home events next week where we'll get a chance to play somebody other than ourselves. And we're excited to see y'all. We appreciate y'all being here. And look forward to seeing you in some purple at all of our games. Thank you.
What time?
Sorry.
What time are the scrimmages?
6 p.m. on Monday.
And
then on the purple white game is 5:30 p.m. on Thursday, and then we are 5:30 on Friday as well.
Any other questions?